bubukan ng ganyan, bubusa pa. Hindi ako nangalala, lapak ko po sa tiyo niya, hindi ko kinuho. Sabi na naman, kukuho kasi lapak ko na. Ati ako ba, maraming palang hindi maganda sa kanya. Pinatatawala, ang daming tao na they terribly miss God's best style, naging judgmental at easily nag-withdraw from relationship. You miss God's best because you become perfectionist. So, alam nyo ano mangyayari sa'yo? If that is your attitude, wala kang kapahingahan from one relationship to another relationship. Pag ikaw isang pastor, wala kang kapahingahan from one church to another church because you're looking for a perfect church. Pag nakita mo, may weakness yung church na yun, nag-design na mo, ito pala yung kasing church na to. Looking for a perfect relationship, that's impossible. Sabihin mo sa tabi mo, impossible. Lots of members are looking for a perfect pastor or a perfect church. Sabi ko, that's impossible. And lots of pastors are looking for a perfect church. And that's also impossible. Nakakapagod yan. Kailanman eh, hindi mo yan matatagpuan. Transferring from one church to another church to another church, you can never find that type of relationship. Even pastors. Dami ko na pastor ang church. Ito nga eh. Last Saturday, iba nag-meeting tayo pastor Ray sa deacons namin. We had a deacons meeting last Saturday doon sa nag-gabi sa Tangoro. Sa deacons meeting namin, dala yung mga asawa, dala yung may dinner fellowship kami. And before we had our meeting, some deacons were sharing their experiences. And maybe we're just opening kung paano nakakalusok. Mga negosyante, nagpakalusok at nagsisinumanin. Nandiyan ako, the two pastors were there. Nandiyan kami. And you know what? We're sharing. Back of my mind, wow! Nagawa ko yan. You were a deacon of this church. At hindi mo ba? Hindi ko sinabi. But back of my mind, parang gusto kong sabihin, bago kami mag-meeting, pwede ba mag-resign ako sa church na ito? Ganito pala yung mga deacons ko. Kasi, I'm working with these people. You know what? I realize I'm not pastoring a perfect church. Amen. Nang nakanay lang sa tupi, huwag maraming pangusok sa mga membro ko na nalikong sa ilan mo sa diyan. They're trying to be reminded. Yan na lang, pangunod ko na. Yung mga may gamay na nabunga pa, so, hindi na. Praise the Lord that we are not perfect, but we have a perfect God. We are in the process of perfection, of sanctification. Palakpakan mo ang palakpakan. Gusto mong magkaroon ng kapahingahan? Treat your brothers and sisters in the Lord the way the Lord is leading you. Amen. Gusto mong magkaroon ng peace? Treat your brothers and sisters in the Lord the way the Lord is speaking. You cannot forgive. What will happen if God will not forgive you also? That is a big question. You cannot forget. What will happen if God will not forget also all the sins that we have committed to Him? Salamat na lang that my God is a gracious God. He is always there to forget and to forget. Palakpakan mo ako yun. Hallelujah. Ano yun? you have to refuse to be one. To be offended. So that grace will be extended and then blessings is received. Verse 15 and 16, we will end with this as a story of great victory. Abraham, Lot is a victim. But here in verse 15 and 16, Abraham is a victim. Abraham is a victim. Abraham is a winner. Lot is a loser. Verse 17 and 18, again, the contrast was met. The contrast. Verse 17 and 18. Ito. Pinamaganda. We will get to this. 17 and 18. And the king, and the king of Sodom, and the king of Sodom went out to meet him at the valley of Shaveh, that is the king's valley, after his return from the defeat of Sidon and the kings who were with him. Okay. Nanalo si Abraham, he rescued Lot, and then the king of Sodom was so excited to meet him, to meet Abraham. Okay. And in verse 18, there is another king who met him. Who is that? King Melchizedek, the king of what? The king of Salem. So two kings met him after his victory. The king of Sodom and the king of Salem. You see how Abraham deals with the two kings. A contrast. Verse 17, verse 21, and verse 24. Abraham's dealing with the king of Sodom. In verse 21, now the king of Sodom said to Abraham, give me the persons and take the goods for yourself. Diba? Nanalo mo sa Abraham eh. So, nabawi niya na si Lot, nabawi niya na yung mga nalihag ng limang kings na to, nabawi niya lahat ng mga goods. So, sabi, excitedly sabi ng king of Sodom, give me the persons, give me the people, and take the goods for yourself. Lahat ng nabawi mo, kayamanan, gold, silver, sayo na yan. Animals, sayo na yan. Sabi ng king of Sodom. You know what is this? Okay. Ano sabi ni Abraham? Verse 22. But Abraham said to the king of Sodom, I have raised my hand to the Lord, God Most High, the possessor of heaven and earth. Next verse. That I will take nothing from a thread to a sandal, spot, and that I will not take anything that is yours. Ang sabi na yun, no? Isang dibot, isang sapatos mo, hindi kumagwa. Because maybe you will say, I have made Abraham rich. In one of our family altar, I explained this to my children. Abraham, this is what we call what? This is a political opportunity. Kung kaibigayan niya itong hangin, this is a political opportunity. A political power and influence. God's because God said, I will make your name great. This is prominence. Palakpakan mo naman ang isang tingin. This is what? This is also an economic opportunity. Kaibigan mo, hari, kaibigan mo, presidente ng Pilipinas. This is an economic. Make business under the protection and the blessings of the king of Sodom. Grabe yung klaseng opportunity mo. This is also a social opportunity. Kaibigan ng hari, ang gandang ipagmayabang. But Abraham turned down all these opportunities. Ibig sabihin, Abraham is not opportunist. Amen. Walang Kristiyanong
oportunista.
Amen. Pag ikay nakakasiguro ng pagpapala mo sa Panginoon.
Amen.
Anong sabi ni Abraham? Thanks, but no thanks. Why? Because God is my blessing. He is my security, my hope, my joy, my peace, my everything. Palapahan mo naman ang Panginoon. Praise God. Paano tayo, Abraham? Baka sabi ni Abraham, baka yumaman pa ako at sabihin mo, alam niyo,